I can pronounce this one, lavender. I love lavender. I love the lavender.
Me too.
And who doesn't love that? It's just such a, man, this is, there's a cottage industry in lavender alone.
There is, products, absolutely.
And products, yes. Man, people making claims about lavender and starting whole health, you know, things.
Yeah, phenomenon.
Lavender, right? Well, we're gonna bring you the real deal all to your home with the only order of the season. Five easy payments of $5.24, one, two, three piece in what we're calling the Blue Jeans Lavender. Only order, free shipping. If you're a big fan, come on in. Do you love the lavender? Mm. We'll take your calls right now.
Take a big whiff of that.
If you love the lavender, I don't know. Who said, I don't love lavender?
No, nobody. Nobody said that ever.
Nobody doesn't like lavender.
Take a big whiff of that. Isn't that amazing? It just feels like a spa. Haven't you just taken a little trip to, I've seen you in your wrapped in your robes with your avocado mask. I know you like to spa.
I've spa'd before.
You've spa'd.
Yeah, Antonella and I on the weekends. We just escape
so
to the spa.
I know picking your favorite plant is like picking a favorite child. You shouldn't do it. But Kelly has irises. I have lavender.
Mm.
I love this plant more than anything. I have it covered all different kinds in my house. I love it so much. I have varieties I've grown over the years that are big and tall and get to be 2 feet maybe tall. And you know what happens when a big rainstorm comes along? Flop. There's a hole. There's a big hole. We talked about not wanting holes in your garden. All of the lavender stalks have flopped over, and now you just have this empty space where you once had beautiful purple
flowers. So what's a cottage farm?
So the great things about these Blue Jeans is that they grow to be about 1 foot to about 15 inches tall.
Technically
so they are
a dwarf
going to be
or
technically
not?
Dwarfed. Absolutely, since the typical lavender is going to be much, much bigger.
Hmm.
So these also, the color, we call them Blue Jean because they have this deep, deeper purple color.
You know what you could call it? You could call it tanzanite is what you could call it.
Oh, we are on a gem kick here.
I mean, it really
is.
That's
this is the jewelry gardening show.
It's not really an amethyst. Is it deeper? There's blues within it.
Well, that's the great thing. If you didn't know, blue is a really hard color to achieve in the garden. We're always searching for that perfect blue flower. And this is close, almost as close as it comes.
This is remarkable.
It's beautiful.
Actually, this is really, I'm not the expert here, but that's pretty.
Plus,
here's what you're physically going to be getting.
And,
one, two, three of these.
And
they're on their way.
On their way. And the great thing about lavender is there's so many uses. It's so versatile. Both the foliage here, the leaves, have such a delicious scent. You can use these in baking, in recipes, and the flowers. The flowers are used, you make sachets, you put them in your shortbread cookies. So many uses for these.
So let's do a one, two, three.
All
two, and three.
Boom.
Give me a timeline.
So this is going to be the end of your first growing season here. Lavender is a nice, fast grower. You will definitely get flowers this year, but this that we have here is going to be more of your second season.
Smells remarkable.
Remarkable.
So again, you could then, let's say it's your third year, and you've got three of these, and they're growing. How much sun are they getting?
Lavender likes full sun.
Great.
So typically, our lavender is definitely drought tolerant and heat resistant. Most lavenders are. But the unusual thing about Blue Jean is what they did is, this is grown in France. A big field of lavenders were trialed.
Wow.
The field is flooded, and then Blue Jean was the only lavender that survived the flood. So not only, that's very unusual for lavenders. So not only is it drought tolerant, but it can handle water. So with these crazy unusual weather we've been having, you don't know if you're gonna get a lot of water or no water. This lavender is a great plant for that.
So you're cutting the roses and now you've got a dozen roses.
Oh, yeah.
So when do you
harvest?
Kind of harvest or dry or use them in cooking? Like when during the year is it best to do that?
So this lavender will bloom for you midsummer. Look at those colors, aren't they beautiful? You snip off those flowers really anytime you want. When they're blooming. So they'll also dry right there on the plant for you.
Oh, they will.
Yeah, they'll dry there and I keep mine during the winter too, because this plant looks like this through the winter. And if you're, don't get super, super cold, the plant will keep its green foliage. The purple flowers will die back, so clip them for sure by the fall,
Does the scent come from the tanzanite, or does it come from the greenery?
It comes from both.
But
you get the really intense scent from the leaves.
From the leaves?
Yes, from the leaves. But it's great. I love this. What I love to do when I'm having a party, just a few girlfriends over, is I'll clip sprigs of each of these lavender and put them in a glass of champagne. And so it makes something, makes an unusual, an ordinary book club just that much more special. Or, there's so many. I love the recipe for shortbread. You make
shortbread cookies.
Serving
champagne at the book club, are you?
Oh, yeah. You do it, too. So
Not a lot of reading going on in my wife's book club, let me tell you. Why is there screaming and glasses breaking?
Oh, I want to be in her book club.
That's
sounds
great.
Fun.
Last minute on you. Go
so
for it.
Absolutely, this lavender is my favorite plant because it produces so much great stuff for you. Plus, we didn't even talk about it's a pollinator magnet. This plant also feeds the butterflies, the hummingbirds. It will bring them to your garden, bring so much joy to you and joy to the earth.
You're back with one more.
One more.
Little tease. What is it?
We've got a raspberry smoothie rose of Sharon tree. We talk about bloom power. This thing will be covered in bloom.